So this topic is around building your local copilot and perform an RAG. I'll try to be do it in 15 minutes. It's a quick journey into the private, secure, and AI-powered assistant. My name is Amit. I am a data engineer in joining in from Singapore, and I've joined Thoughtworks like 3 years back. So thanks for joining. So I believe pretty much everybody would have interacted with ChatGPT or any kind of a coding assistant online. And if not, then yeah, you must have heard about it and probably know about like what it can do. And you might have wondered, like, while using it, you might feel like, yeah, there's some data which I don't want to put it on online, because most of these tools are online based or cloud based. And you might feel like, yeah, how about if something I could have it more private or more local, so that or there could be some other limitations around, you know, the usage or the limitation on the tokens or something. So let's try and go local. With that, you can actually choose your own model. You will have a choice of models based on what task you want to do. There is no data sent on the web. Whatever you post will remain over in the system. You can customize your domain. You can have multiple things interacting to each other. And you're not limited to only the feature which is available through one interface. You can use it more in more secure environment, and there are no API or usage limits when you try to do it local. So what's in the store today? We are going to build a local copilot, then we'll build a RAG tool, and all in 15 minutes. Okay, so a couple of things. What tooling we need for this? So I have set up this demo with using this LM Studio, which actually hosts a model. It also provisions your model and give you a accessible URL. You also need a VS Code and a particular plugin, which will actually be interacting with LM Studio. Hugging Face for, you know, because it's a repository of all different types of models. So we need that for downloading our model. And a decent machine, could be around RAM, 16 GB. I'll talk a bit more about some of the limitations on the hardware side. Okay, so as a flow of steps is mostly like setting up the LM Studio, then we'll try to search and download a model. We'll set up the VS Code extension and point it to the LM Studio and start coding with our own copilot. Right, let's see it in action. So what I do is I first, sorry. Yeah, I'll first try to go to this LMstudio.ai website and try to download LM Studio. So for this demo, I've already done this. Once you install it, you will see an interface like this. The next you do is you go and try to find your model. So let's see. So you can always go and find whatever model you want, and you can look through a few things around like the number of downloads, any people chatting over the message on here, like the pros and cons of a particular model and what exactly the model does best. So based on that, you can choose and download the model. So I have actually downloaded so once you have downloaded, you will actually see the list of models which you will have here. The one which we are going to use today is a particular model here. And yeah, so it gives you a nice chat interface. There are a lot of other tons of features which you can anyway explore. And yeah, so this is something you've got the downloaded model running on your local as a chat interface. Let me So it's something similar what you want to do, giving a quick prompt. It tells you like which model it's using, and it's pretty intuitive, quite similar to ChatGPT. While it is right, let me. So this is something I just want to quickly show you. Like, you can use it for your coding help. Stop and then give another prompt. So you see, like, yeah, it's building up the code, and you can interact with it and get some help. Next is I will switch to just Studio. So this is a flavor of having your own copilot. So I'll download the, I mean, you can anyway download the Visual Studio from the website, and then I will go to the extension. There's this extension called Code GPT, which you can use to interact with your LM Studio. So just before that, let me show you quickly. There's something like a terminal type of interface where you can actually provision this model. It's very easy to use. You just need a toggle to start, and your model will be provisioned as per these URLs. Yep. So once you are here, once you have also in Visual Studio, once you have installed the extension, you will see a Code GPT a panel on the left, which you can open up, and then here you can actually use any model which is available online, which will interact with online, for example. But then because we want to interact with our provision model, so you come here, local model and LM Studio. And that's all. So let's see if I clear this. Let me try a prompt here. So if I type something here, you see the rule, the logs here is actually showcasing that it is interacting with a local model. And here is on the chat window here, it's like a copilot similar interface which where you can interact with. So here I'm saying like, okay, I need some help with something around like data engineering, building an ETL pipeline, a skeleton of it. So it will understand and come up with the response back. So yeah, so there's like tying together the model, which is on local, which is provisioned by LM Studio, and then integrating with your Visual Studio interface. Moving on. So next we have set up things. Now let's talk a bit more about some of the choices. So for laptops, and depending on your hardware, you can choose smaller or bigger model. Rule of thumb is something like if a model size the which we call as tokens is a billion, then the RAM should be half of that in GB. So if you see, I have the model which I chose was around 8 billion. Sorry, yeah, 8 billion. The RAM was I think 16 GB in this case. So it works fine. So similarly, you can choose it accordingly. One of the format of the model is GGUF, which is actually readily available on Hugging Face, and which can be used for LM Studio. Now, let's make this chat smarter by implementing this RAG tool. So I have a small code, which is, so I don't want to go into all the details of it, but it's just like you can say like 50 lines of code. Here I am building something like there is a path to doc. There's a link to the model, which is what the provision by LM Studio. This is a place where I'm reading all the docs. So I think, yeah, this is where I am provisioning my model using the OpenAI library. Then I'm actually building this embedding model also and getting it. So this is also a locally deployed, locally downloaded model. Then it's to check whether, so this is something like building your vector database, and if the database is there and it is cached, so it will actually go to the first part, the if block. If it's not cached, then it will try to build it from scratch. So there's a bunch of code around here, and you see I'm using a FAISS vector database. So basically it's like giving your docs, giving the embedding model, and where should it be saved. Then you use vector store index and mention like what exactly the LLM you want to use. And that's pretty much, I am using the fast API so that it gives you a nice interface. A quick recap of what exactly is RAG. So if you see, so we have a few models here. Basically, this is a retrieval backend module where it takes a user query, it try to retrieve the document from the vector store with the subset of document. With the user query, it passed to LLM, and then LLM understand the document and come up with the response to the query. Okay, so maybe I can start the server. You will see, let me show you this. It takes a few more seconds to start. And because I'm using the LLM hosted URL, it will actually talk to the model here. Sorry for the delay. Maybe I can talk a bit about here. So if you see my docs are here, there are a bunch of document, and in fact and the model is here. This is the embedding model, sorry, the local embedding model is here, which is and the cache is over here. So everything is locally set up here. Okay, so I have the server provision. So using fast APIs actually gives you this a bit of a chunky out-of-the-box UI. Let's see quickly. Yeah. So here you see the logs are appearing, and it has initialized and a link to this one. Now, so I'll just give a quick prompt to the right here. You will see the messages here with the, so this is a verbose mode, and you can always strip down the logging. So yeah, so you see the message was sent, and the response from the agent is here. Quickly, just want to quickly check, is this really talking and understanding my documents? So it has come up with like, yeah, document appear to be a receipt from Crab, which is a ride-hailing service. And some of that content is not mentioned in the doc as such, but it, because the model has been built and is ready for, you know, interaction. So it has come up with these responses. And yeah, that's mostly about mostly about the demo I wanted to show. Quickly wrapping up. Yes, about the security, it's not 100% guaranteed, even if you are running things on local, because once you download the model, it should be actually from a trusted source. Do your own research on the model, because there could be some vulnerabilities. Normally, Hugging Face is actually a trusted source, but people, it's a community-based open. So people will talk about if there is a model which may not be right or has some issues here or there. Plus, a good number to watch is the number of downloads of a model. If the model is good enough, then obviously yeah, it is more in use. And have a sensible guardrails in place when interacting with local setup. So try to avoid as much as possible to, you know, post any sensitive item or things which you should not, password or API keys, those kind of things. Yeah. I have tested the whole solution with internet off, so everything works fine. Yeah. So yeah, just to recap, it's local Copilot setup and RAG powered assistant, all done locally and fast. These are some of the references I've mentioned in the deck. You can have a look. If there are any questions I can address now, yeah, let me know. Otherwise, we can always catch up separately. Thank you. And this is a QR code and a link to the feedback. I would love to get some feedback on my presentation. Thank you, everyone.